the Feather. Welcome back to the YouTube channel. Today I'm doing a room decor video, and it's going to be full of organization, DIYs, just anything to make your room spectacular. So let's just jump right into the video. So for this swirl coaster, you're going to need three colors of clay, and I'm using polymer clay. So right now, what you have to do is swirl each of your separate colors into snakes, and then mush them all together until you get a swirled kind of look. After you have mushed all your clay together, now you have to roll it into one giant snake. And by the way, I got my clay from Michaels, and it is Sculpey clay. So after you rolled it up into a snake, now you're just gonna roll it up into a spiral looking shape. And when you're done with that, you just need to take a bowl or your hands and flatten it out. Glitter is optional.
Okay, wait, do it.
So make sure to put it in a oven safe bowl, and then just preheat your oven. What it says on your package, just pop the baby in and then set it the time to when it's going to need to be. Mine was 275 for 15 minutes, and this came out really cute, and I hope you guys try it out. So the next thing is a flower wall, and you see all the leaves and stuff. I had that painted on for a really long time. But for this craft, you're going to need poster putty, which I bought from Michaels, and fake flowers, which I also bought from Michaels. And you just put circles of poster putty onto where you want your flowers, and then you just stick the flowers into the poster putty, and that's pretty much it. It's really cute, and it totally just adds a pop of color into your room. For this initial painting, you're going to need a canvas, two kinds of paint, a sponge, a paintbrush, stickers, black paint, and a plate. So first, what you want to do is paint your whole entire canvas one color. Doesn't matter which one you want, but just fill the whole entire thing up. Just keep your eyes on me. I said you're holding back. She said, shut up. Take your next color and then take a sponge and start blotting that color onto your canvas. And it doesn't matter how big the sponge is or how big the blots are, just try to fill it up, but keep a lot of purple or the color that's below. Then you can go over the pink or the one that you use on top with the bottom color, so you make sure you have every color that's dispersed equally. Make sure you let your canvas dry, and when it's done drying, it's time for you to make your initial. So I was making H with masking tape. Do not do duct tape because it will rip off your paint, so make sure you use masking tape or the blue tape. And I was just making my initial, and after that, I just transferred it onto my canvas, and I also added my little butterflies. And this might sound crazy to you, we're gonna take out the black paint and paint over the whole entire thing. Don't worry, this your masterpiece colors will still be there. So paint the whole thing and try to keep it in the same strokes, because if you don't, it kind of gets messed up and it can go under the stickers and it kind of can result in not having the perfect initial or perfect like outline of your stickers. So make sure to be very careful, do not go too crazily. Thing is painted, let it dry so everything is completely dry, because if you take it off while it's still wet, it won't result in a good clean cut. So here it was completely dry and I started taking off everything, and you can see that some black did come under the stickers, but we can always touch it up, which I'm going to show later in the video. So just peel everything off, and if it doesn't come off completely, don't worry, because like I said, we can always touch it up. So here I'm touching it up. So I just took the purple because that was the first color, and I just painted all the black spots, and I did not dab it because I'm gonna dab over with my pink, but I'm using my finger because I have no little sponges that are that small. So just do little dots of pink and take your finger and just dab it a bit, and make sure you use, like, you don't overuse one color, and just fix everything that you made a mistake on. So next is organization. So I got these really cute bins at Michael's for $9. They were 40% off, so they would have been $15. So it was an awesome buy. So what I did is just take all my lotions and Bath and Body Works stuff and put it in my pink bin. And then I really didn't have anything to put in my blue bin, but I'll for sure find something later. And it's just a good thing, so if you need something easily, you can just pick it out, but it's also good for organizing. So the next thing you can use for organizing is mason jars. So here, if you haven't seen my soap video, I'm just putting all my little soaps into the jar, and same with my hand sanitizers.
Woo!
Yes.
Concentration pace. Go put those scissors away, girl.
What?
Put the scissors away.
I thought that wasn't real.
You're such an actress.
Don't play with scissors, kids.
It's a safety hazard.
Make sure when you hold them like this.
Yes, and don't wave them at the camera woman's face.